Good morning, everyone. So it's coffee and chat time with me. It's a nice day in Ireland today. We're supposed to have 2 days of nice weather. So I'm just sitting here in the morning having my coffee, contemplating the day's training and jobs I have to do. Quite a lot of online stuff again, such as the routine at the moment, and I'm currently trying to open my gym. Having to put in Ireland, I don't know from where you are watching in the rest of the world, we have to kind of have safety protocols in place, lines on the floor and signs on the wall, and things measured out. So this would be the main gym area. Our martial arts studio, I have one or two instructors that do kind of fitness classes in there as well. So we changed, it used to be just like a traditional martial arts studio with weapons up on the wall, and you kind of like, you walked in, you thought you'd walked into China, but I changed that just because the it was always nice, it was a nice idea, something I always wanted, but the cultural idea of having that little mini China in the room, and then other fitness instructors coming in to do general fitness things, just didn't work, so I had to scrap that, unfortunately. So that martial arts room has to be put markings on the floor and stuff like that. So when we'll get back to training, contact sports, I suppose, will be next month. Anyway, I was sitting here having a coffee. My body's in bits from yesterday's training, hard training yesterday. I was thinking to myself, I don't know, I must have read it today or seen someone say, but it's so common, I see in traditional martial arts, is people do their, particularly forms, usually, you know, if you YouTube Chinese martial arts, you'll find forms. Even in my own channel now, you know, it's forms, that's because I can't hit anyone. I'm not supposed to get close enough to them. So either it is people tend to not want to show applications, or they simply can't. Probably in China and stuff, I see, you know, a lot of them, the things I do, the applications I do see are, fuck me. There's a monk, he posts up a lot of videos. I think it's Shida Young, I don't care. He's good videos on Shaolin, traditional Shaolin. But has any of you watched his applications? Fucking hell. Saw him showing applications, I think, of Da Hong Quan, you know, the low drop stance, sitting stance with a chop in the hand, and the guy attacked, he blocked, and then jumped down to a low stance and chopped him in his shin with his palm. I fucking had to switch it off. It's like, lads, live in a dream world. Absolute dream world. A common thing you'll hear people say is, oh yeah, we have that in our style, you know. So you'll see MMA, wrestling, or some kickboxing, Muay Thai, or something. Oh look, we have that movement in our form, look, we have it here in the form, we have it in our system. So common. And then people, you know, there's a really good video I even shared, it was quite good, where they showed somebody was doing, I think, Okinawan karate applications, and then you showed those so that you would do the kata, then they would show the application, then you would see, then they would show footage of it being applied in full contact. Usually 99% of the videos within MMA. So basically it shows there's nothing new, we all have those applications. I agree, but there is a big difference. Knowing it and having it in your system and being able to do it are completely different worlds apart. And that's the common thing. So, oh look, we have that in the system. Okay, if you've got it in your system, if you can't apply it, you know, I have a lot of things in my system, you know. You might have a cartwheel or something in your system. Doesn't make you a fucking gymnast, you know. Being able to apply it doesn't mean you can go to a competition and win. The same with the martial arts moves, you know. Within my systems that I practice, there's probably every single move there that's in martial arts, but ones that I can actually apply to a resisting opponent that's trying to do you harm is not so easy. So having it in your system and being able to apply it in your system, or just apply it, are two different, completely different worlds. And what's the difference is how you train predominantly. who you train with. You know, you have instructors that they train, and maybe they only have their club and they only train with their students. So they probably don't really spar or fight with them. And there's always that teacher-student relationship. So the students are generally not really trying to resist you. You know, look, I've been there. I've been for years. You know, the instructor goes to do an application on you, and kind of you can feel it's not particularly good, but you just go with it to show them face. Yeah, you go with it. You're not sparring, you're not fighting. There's an awkward time where, you know, I'll let you do an application on me, but I know that you really probably couldn't do this application, but I'll let you do it. And then, you know, that's traditional martial arts for you. You know, that's the difference. You know, you go down to your local boxing, MMA club, or wrestling club, jiu-jitsu, Thai boxing club. Okay, you'll do your techniques, but then you'll have free fighting, and you'll be able to see whether you can apply it or not. And that's probably the biggest thing, is having a distinction between having it in your system and being able to apply it. They're completely different worlds apart. And then obviously, as people get older in martial arts, they acquire knowledge, and then they tend to contemplate things more. And then they somewhere along the line, you seem to people that get older seem to suddenly think they get more skill. They never really fought when they were younger, and then suddenly when they're older, they suddenly become killing machines. But you've never fucking fought, you know? You've become more theoretical, and your ideas have become more grandeur as you think you can do stuff, but you never could, so you can't now, you know? Why do we see, you know, you can see 60, 70-year-old people doing jiu-jitsu quite effectively. Certain arts, some arts you can do more effective than others. Others you can't, and that's the problem sometimes as teachers, as they get older, and they never had a good grounding in real combat, as they get these crazy ideas, and then it gets even worse. They teach them, and then they yeah, we have this and that, and you know, the fact is, combat, like anything, you know, as you do get to a certain age, you know, there's a reason why you don't see 70-year-olds going for the title belt. You know, just ain't gonna happen. You know, and people love, you can still practice martial arts to a high level, and you can still train that. You know, that's important and that's good, but common fucking sense, guys. Please, you know, you're 70-year-old. You're not gonna get in the ring with a fighter in his prime. Okay, it's not gonna happen. Okay, all the guy has to do is just get you tired, and then you're done for. You know, there's a very famous catch wrestler, Carl Koch, and he says your biggest weapon, your biggest tool, your biggest hold was like your kind of your locks and your submissions was your conditioning. You know, and that's the truth of it. Okay. So, you know, anyway, that's my thoughts for this morning, as I'm gonna train, and you know, I'm still doing no contact stuff. And I think to myself, all right, it's all well and good when I'm feeling in good shape, doing good training, but I know it's gonna, when we get back in and I start fighting and sparring and going against high level guys, you know, it's gonna suck, because you're gonna be like, shit, I'm getting my ass whipped here. I'm gonna have to. This isn't so easy, you know. And that's the truth. When you do your forms and your stuff, you're always winning. You feel strong. You feel great. You start to feel your level is higher than it is, because you can perform something in the air, which your level has gone up in performing things in the air. Performing a form well in the air is one step. It's one piece of a puzzle to show you can move well. Does that mean you can apply it? That's two completely different worlds. Even if you play train with very good focus and intent, that's only one part of the puzzle. Okay, I would say, you know, if you did all those forms and that aspect of it, but never mixed with other high level fighters and never actually tested the stuff, your chances of applying it, I'd be tempted to say zero, because it's never been proved to me otherwise. You know, food for thought, as we're training by ourselves now at the moment. You know, just because we have something in the system, it's there, you get explained the application, you show the application, doesn't mean you can do the application. if you want to do the application, you're going to have to go out of your way to test it in environments where people are not just trying to resist you, but trying to do you harm. That's the difference. You get someone just tried to resist me. Yeah, but he's not trying to hit you back. It's easy to do something when someone's not trying to hurt you back, when you're not having to defend yourself. So you see in traditional martial arts, I attack, he blocks, then he blocks again, then he blocks again. You're fucking fighting someone that just thinks about blocking. Well, when someone tries to hit me, I try to hit them back. You know, and that's what's lacking in most of the people, when people do applications, is the person is not actually like putting the head down and going for you. And when you go, when you train that, it'll be enlightening for you. I think if you do traditional martial arts and you haven't done that, you need to do it. And you can contact me then, because you'll probably say I'm quitting traditional martial arts, is of no use. A lot of times you might be right. A lot of the stuff isn't. It's just because of the way you train it and the way you think the application is going to be. But anyway, that's my morning contemplation. A little bit long. If you've listened this far, fair dues. So, time to train. Time to think. Focus where we are. Don't forget, I'm doing online training. Personal training. What's the difference between this type of training and the other stuff I'm doing? Simply that I'm not just sticking out videos and putting it online, like, you know, you there's millions of online tutorials where you're just like, here's a form, here's a breakdown of it, here's applications, go. And then this is live sessions online. We have you on Zoom. We speak, we interact, and I coach you, and I do a needs analysis, just like a strength and conditioning. I look at you, what do you need? I base the next session on a syllabus, but what do you need? So it's interactive, more training. So it's not just like where you go online, oh, I can rent an instructional DVD for $19, and it shows me everything. Yeah, that's cool. I've done that. You know, this is an interactive learning where, you know, it's as close as we can get to you coming into my gym or meeting me in training without me being physically be able to do applications on you. If you're interested in that, have a look at the last video I posted. I'll stick a link in the comment section where you can find that video where I talk a little bit about our online stuff. All right, guys, keep it real.